26-year-old Dina has been living in Singapore for 10 years now. 2 years ago, she became a Singapore permanent resident. The assistant engineer at a semiconductor company has not dated anyone in the last 10 years. But she's hoping that will change soon. She recently signed up for an event for singles organised by Romancing Singapore.
I haven't go through a date before, so maybe certain things I don't really know about it. So I think if go through them, they can help us to choose a location, you know, to maybe they will match someone which we have, not much different gap, you know, either it's education background or age background.
When you were in school, did you interact with any boys?
Of course. I did admire, you know, guys. I think it's quite normal, but because I came to Singapore since very young, so my thoughts slightly mature than whatever those people have same age as me. So the way I'm thinking is different. I'm looking for someone who's more mature. Not just the age. I think mature is in physically, also in mentally.
But even though Dingna is ready to date, finding Mr. Right is turning out to be an uphill battle.
What do you think is the biggest misconception that Singaporeans have of China women?
That in some way, so-called in Chinese, they call Huli Jing. They come here to, you know, just to look for a husband.
With this kind of stigma, do you think it's difficult for you to find a partner?
Yes. A little bit, okay. I can't deny that. It's because when you're saying, oh, you're from China, so the first thought is she come to stealing a husband, or, you know. But after that, after go through some time, they find out that, oh, okay, I'm almost like Singaporean.
Dingna calls herself a 50% Singaporean, 50% China Chinese. But somehow she will always be tagged as a China woman.
还有几个问题就是关于新加坡人对大陆来的女生的一些看法，有些人会觉得大陆女生是来这边抢老公，
好像很多人，但是这些东西看个人，但是也有一些啦，各方面每个地方他都会有一些就是说非面的负，还有正面的嘛，有好的有坏的，那都肯定是不能否认，就是说完全没有是吧，但是也不能说完全都是。如果是有人这样跟你讲的话，你会怎么反应？
我觉得因为从中国来的中国那么大一个国家，从中国的人来这边的话，他肯定会有不同的目的的。但是像我们这样的学生，我们都是 scholar， 我们是来学习的，我们不是有这种目的而来的，我们是为了追求我们的梦想才来到这里，我们绝对不会去为了这种很狭隘的思想然后才来到这里。如果说一个人是真心爱一个人，他肯定是不会在乎他的一切，所以说不会为了金钱去那样。如果说是建立在金钱上的爱情或者是什么的话，那一定是没有任何价值的。
电视里面看多了也对啊，电视里面看的挺多。你说，作为如果我是那个人的太太的话，如果是别的女的来抢我老公，那我肯定会不高兴了，是吧？不过有的女孩子会有这样的想法，哎，
每个人都会有那种想法，
人人不一样，哎，不可能每个人都会有，
人都有想法的，
对啊，
是，
对，想法不一定都是一样的，哎。
我是说有一些是吧？我觉得新加坡人对我们中国女孩子误解真的是蛮大的。很多时候哦，他们会讲，哎，中国女孩子不好啦，怎样为了钱怎样怎样这样子啊。可是哈，我想说的是一点，中国女孩子是有这样，但是不可以绝对的去讲她们哪里都有好的，哪里也都有坏的，对吗？不可以讲一棒子打死说哦，中国的女孩子就一定不好。
这一点我是绝对不认同的。你是有看过、有听过这样的例子？
没有看过，但是我有听说过了，有听说过很多新加坡人讲啊，说是他们的老公怎样和中国女孩子怎样怎样这种情况咯。我是觉得这种人真的是很丢脸的，因为中国的名声很多地方都是因为这种女孩子给败掉的。我不觉得我们真中国很穷到要死，还要说在国外一定要这样那样的，可能吧，每个人的想法不一样。
那你觉得为什么会有这么多女生在这边是这样的呢？懂事很穷吗？还是怎样家里？那是什么呢？可能是生活无聊吧，找一个人这样子，我也不懂。Dingna
hasn't gone on any dates yet, but the cheerful girl is not placing too much hope in it to avoid disappointment.
For Chinese, we believe in fate. If we, the poor person have really have 有缘, you know the fate, then they will be together. If not, no matter how hard, it's very difficult.
But Dina doesn't have to worry too much about finding a boyfriend. It seems local men are increasingly taking to China women.
If pretty, why not?
More on that in the next clip.